If part of my scalp needed to be shaved, shoven, I don't know the word. And I think it will be interesting for me as well, because I then can kind of see the evolution that is me. Well, hello, my lovely nestlings, and welcome to today's video, where I'm just going to chat a little bit and try out some new goodies. I have a new bronzer from Too Faced. People said that this was perfect if you have an olive complexion, so we're going to see if people were right. I also have the new duochrome, or at least three of the new duochrome liquid eyeshadows from Essence that I want to try out in the same order, because I ordered some other stuff. I was able to pick out a pair of falsies from Boozy Shop, so I want to try those out. I think that's it, right? Yeah, I think that's it, because I don't really want to make the video too long. I don't want to try too much stuff in one go. I do have other new stuff, because I also ordered the Moonspell palette from Lunar Beauty, finally. I have been wanting that palette for ever since it released. Finally, I ordered it. I also have some PR. I can show you the PR palette. It's the Moon Monsoon, the Desert Monsoon palette from What's Up Beauty, or What's Up Makeup. It's very, very pretty, and I thought about using this. But honestly, the look that I have in mind is so, so simple that I don't want to use this palette for it, because I want to give it its moment to shine, because it's very, very pretty. So a video with this one is coming as well, but I think that's it. And I also kind of wanted to chat a little bit about the new addition to the family. Yes. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45, from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you are older like me, find everything a little bit more difficult to apply, where to put everything, what color looks good on you, what foundations are good for us older boys and girls, and everything in between. But also, if you have an olive complexion and want to know the products that look good on you, then this is definitely the channel for you. Also, if you kind of want to have a little bit of fun with makeup, make sure you are subscribed, because I'm fun. Or at least I think so. And if you haven't run away screaming now, just hit the subscribe button, because this is the place for you. Just do so and become part of my nestling family. One of the nestlings. Because we are having a blast here on the internet. Yes, I kind of want to give you an update as well. Oh yes, I also have ADHD. Can you tell? I have done a video with this one, the new Revolution CC skin tint. In the video, I will link the video down below. Spoiler alert, I like the product, but it makes me a Noompa Loompa. In that video, I mixed in a green color corrector, which kind of worked, but I still looked a little bit orange. I have also tried it just on its own. It's pretty, very, very pretty, but I'm orange. So what did I actually do today? I mixed in a blue, where is it? I mixed in a blue color correcting primer, and that worked very, very well. And this is one from AOA Studio. I think that other brands have it as well. I will link where you can find this. Maybe I need a, I don't know. I will probably need a different one once, because I'm so happy that I finally found what works without making it feel very, very heavy, because I really do like the product. Yes, the rest of the makeup will be listed down below. It is time for bronzer though. The Too Faced, what is it?
Soleil Longwear Matte Bronzer.
Now, it smells of cocoa powder. When I saw it on Beauty Bay, that's where I ordered it, it looked like this. And I was like, okay, well, fine. It's a bit dark, but that's okay. I have usually bronzers that are suited for an olive complexion are on the darker side. Because apparently brands, there are more and more brands who are noticing that they're also light, very pasty pale to basically medium olive toned people, and they are gearing a bit more towards that. But yeah, usually bronzer wise they are very, very dark, so I thought, well, okay, I can work with that, that's okay. And then when I got it in and I saw it, I was like, oh, it's very, very pale. So yeah, now I do like a light bronzer. And I think it will give me a hint right now. I will like it more in winter though, I think, color-wise. But I'm actually very, very excited to try it. Yes, maybe I should have made pictures before I used it, but that's okay. I'm going to use a real hairbrush, because this is the brush that I use for bronzer. And because it's a very, very pale one, I can kind of get away with a little bit more. So I have set my face. Oh, it smells of chocolate. And this is how I always apply my bronzer and powder product. So I tap first to just make sure that where I'm going to blend It has set and then I'm going to blend. Now, I don't know if it translates on camera though, but I can see it in the mirror. It's very pretty. And again, I really like a pale bronzer. Especially in winter, because honestly, you know, where I live, Dutch coast, winter, it's... When I see people who are overly bronzed, then, and it's... Everyone should do their own thing. That's the beauty of makeup. For me personally, I'm like, yeah, that's not the look I'm going for. But I really, really like the way this is looking. I also want a little bit on my nose. Also, I haven't put on highlighter and blush yet. Looks pretty. I think it looks... Yeah. But so far, I think it's very, very pretty. Yeah. That's good. Okay, so for blush and bronzer, I have the Charlotte Tilbury blush in Walk of No Shame, which was a present. The highlighter as well. And I was like, maybe it will be very pretty with kind of the neutrally look that I have in mind today. And then I want my Becca highlighter. So that's what I'm going to do. And I'm going to chat about the tattoo a little bit. But first I need a brush. It's the same tattoo artist that did my Bumblebee. And he's just very, very talented. And he loves black work. He loves dot work as well. So we were actually talking about doing a rose. Putting a rose on top there. And then he was drawing and he was like, yeah, but it will not fit. If I were to do a rose, it will be so, so big that it will probably be a rose yay big. That was not the idea. And the one criteria that I had is that I did not want it in my face here. That it is in front here. I wanted to stop at my jawline. So that was the only thing that I had. So when he messaged me Friday morning, I was like, oh dear. Oh yeah, I'm going to... Oh yeah, highlighter. I was like, oh dear, now what are we going to do? Because if we cannot come to an agreement, then I cannot get a tattoo and I will have to wait. And I don't want that. Basically, that's, you know. And I was like, he had an idea and he tried to explain it to me, but I just could not see what he saw. So I was like, can you maybe make a rough sketch and then send it to me so I can see what you mean? He did. And then when I saw it, I was like, oh yeah, that's the one. I messaged him back. I said, that's the one. That's what we're going to do. And then he was like, oh, I'm so, so happy that we are in agreement. And the only thing though, you will probably have to shave, we will probably have to shave a little bit of your scalp. And I was like, okay, that's okay. So yeah, why? Because on the back, and I hope you can see when I sit like this. So here it is a little bit on my scalp. And yeah, I have a buzz cut. I have had a buzz cut for years. And it's the best thing that I ever did. There is, by the way, a Q&A coming up. And one of the questions was why I buzzed it off. I don't know if I will have time to explain it in that video. But to make a very long story... Did I do a dedicated video? Maybe I will do a dedicated video on that. Because there are more people who are asking. So if you want to have just a separate video. A Get Ready With Me style video. Where I go over why I shave my hair. And how that whole process went. Because honestly, I don't know if I can answer that in 5 minutes. So I think I will just make that a separate video. You know, or maybe I will do a live soon again. Something like that. But that... It is coming up, the reason behind me shaving my head. Honestly, it's the best thing I ever did. But yeah. But I have also last summer shaved my head completely bald. Because I don't really remember why. I think I just wanted to try it. So I don't mind that at all. And you know what? I have a 2-day buzz cut, which is basically almost the same length as if I were to shave it without the comb, you know? So there's that. I like this. I like the way that my skin is looking like this. I like it a lot. Okay. Eyes. That's what we're going to do right now. I pulled one of the Catrice 5 in a box ones in golden nude. This one is vegan. Yeah. When I do a look the way that I have it planned in my head, I don't use an eye primer. So I'm not going to use an eye primer. Just so you know. So that not that you're like, you did not use an eye primer. Nope. And I'm not going to either because... The whole purpose of a look like this is that it is very, very simple. When I got my tattoo, it's kind of the look that I did. Because what am I going to do right now? I am going to frame my eyes very, very lightly. So create a little bit of depth with this little palette. And then I'm going to, I think I'm going to use this one. I am going to do a wing and then put this one on top. That's the plan. So that the wing is kind of the star of the show, you know. And I actually did something similar when I went to get my tattoo. I did a wing and then I put this on top, which is a liquid eyeshadow from 5050 Makeup. When this dries, it's not going anywhere. So I was like, yeah, that's a good idea. And I did. And it did not go anywhere because it was still on my face in the evening. Why is there hair here? Because I have cats. Yes, I will show the cats as well, indeed. If I can find them all. Otherwise, I will show pictures. I think I'm going to set my eyeshadow first. Or my, not really the primer, but the foundation that I have on my eyeballs. Yes, I know who am I. So I'm just going to use the mattes here in the palette. It's not going to be very, very complicated. Oh yeah, I think I was shaving my hair, right? So yeah, I don't really mind it shaving my scalp anyway, because I'm like, you know what, it is back very, very quickly. But I had thought about it, because if part of my scalp needed to be shaved, shoven, I don't know the word, or the correct one, because in Dutch we would kind of say then shoven, and that's not, yeah, I know it's not correct in English, but yeah, so I knew we had to shave part of the scalp. Let's go with that. Yes, that's better for me. And but if we only shave a part of it, when it kind of grows back, because I know that I cannot use the hair trimmer, buzz cut, thingamajingy for a few weeks until I'm sure that it is healed, you know, because otherwise I may rip it open and I don't want that. So I was like, okay, so I probably cannot shave my hair or my, yeah, hair, lack thereof, for a few weeks, 2 or 3 weeks or something like that. But if part of the scalp is bald, really, really bald, it will grow out unevenly. And when you have a buzz cut, it's very, very noticeable. So I was like, yeah, I don't want that. Then I was like, you know what? Let me just shave everything myself. And also I wanted, because I know how my scalp reacts when I shave everything off, I thought, I kind of want to do it in the morning so that my scalp can get a little bit of time to, well, readjust, you know, and be not as angry with me anymore. So that was that's what I did in the morning. And then when I got in the tattoo studio, he was like, did you just shave your entire scalp? I was, yeah, why not? Really? You're a badass, he said. Yeah, but it's only common, it's, you know, common sense, basically, because I am going to, we're going to have to shave part anyway. So yeah, and otherwise it will grow unevenly. And I cannot, I detest that. Oh, it's such a nice palette, this. This is Blackwork Dotting. I don't know if there's a, I think it's Blackwork Dotting. I think that's how they call it as well. I want it a little bit softer, so I'm going to go over it with the lightest shade here. And what I can do to add a little bit of sparkle is use a little bit of this one, just with a very, very big fluffy brush. And then just kind of dust it on the lid, just a little, just in the inner corner, to give a little bit of a hint of a sparkly bit. And you can enhance that if you want to. I think I will, just in the inner corner. Just to open up the eye a little bit. Yes. Okay, now I am going to put on my eyeliner ring. And I am just using my NYX Epic Ink liner for that. Unfortunately, I don't think that you can see what I'm doing. I do have a video on it, so I will link the video down below as well. And if I don't forget, I will also put it underneath the cards. But I'm just going to put on the wing really, really quickly. Okay, the wings are on. And now it is time to go over it with a line. Let me swatch them first so you can see. So now it's a question of which one do I want to wear today. I think I want to wear this one. Yeah, the orangey one. I wanted to wear them. So, and the orangey one is called Chromology, something like that. So yeah, what I'm going to do is I'm going to grab a very, very tiny brush. If I can find one. Where is the tiny brush? Yes, here it is. So it's a very, very tiny angled brush like that. Where did I get this? AliExpress. If I can find them, I will link them down below. But it's basically a very, very small angled brush. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to do this. And then I'm going to grab from the wand with the brush, and I'm just going to paint on top of the black that I have, but I do want my magnifying part for that, I think. I'm just going to paint it on top. I usually don't use stuff like this, just all over the lid, but I think like this it's very, very cute. You can use these all over the lid, I feel. Very, very pretty. I think I'm going to grab the pinky one next. Put that just next to it or something. Or maybe I should have started with this one, I don't know. And if you were to use them on different bases, you can play with the shift that they have. So I'm very lightly also mixing it on top of the... here. Nice, okay. Let's do the blue on the... Let's play with the blue on the wing. I think the whole tattoo took about 3.5 to 4 hours, I believe. Pain level wise, it wasn't that bad. Some parts were more painful, you know. Just behind my ear on my scalp was not very nice. But overall, honestly, it was not that bad. You know, a tattoo always kind of hurts. It was a whole new experience though, because it was, oh, that's cute, because it was dot work. And I have never had a dot work tattoo before. So it was, for me, it was new as well. It took a little bit longer, I think, than if you were to just have shaded it. But it does look very, very pretty. It brings a certain lightness and airiness into the tattoo. That makes it not look like cover up anymore, you know? I'm putting it a little bit on my lower lash line because I kind of like that, I think. I'm actually just putting a little bit of my face highlighter in the inner corner. Because I think that's cute. The pencils I used will be listed down in the description box at least. Okay. Let me put on the falsies and then I will be right back. So the falsies are on as well. They are cute. They are maybe a little bit light and soft for what I usually go for. But they are very pretty. That's it. They are very pretty. They could be natural lashes for me. They could be dramatic lashes for someone else. These are the style Sarah Merrick. I think that's the style. But I'm actually... I think that's the style. That's what it says in the box. So yeah, the rest I will be listed down below. I did top it off just with a gloss. It's actually my favorite gloss right now. It's from Lethal Cosmetics in the shade Nova. Because for me, a look like this, it's just nice and fresh. And lip oil is also good. But yeah, I like it like this. I did check outside. Or at least not outside, but in natural light. I don't look orange, for which I'm very, very happy. The bronzer looked nice as well. And I don't know how it translates on camera. But when I see it in the mirror, it gives a nice wash. It is a little bit more... It's a better color than the one that I have from Kaleidos. So the one that I have from Kaleidos for me is also more of a wash of color. But it's a little bit more red than this one. I like it. The bronzer. Yeah, I think it's very, very pretty. And I think it is maybe more on the neutral side for me. So it does give me a hint of warmth. But I don't feel like it gives me a very orange cast. I like the way that it applies. I like the way that it blended out. I like the smell. I like the color. I really do like it. And I like the component as well. Do I wish it was a tad darker? Maybe. But also, I'm very happy that I now have a bronzer again. That will probably work very well for me in winter. And I cannot wait to try it in winter as well. Then the next thing that was new are these, right? Yeah. So the multichromies, yeah. Looking at the multichromes, how they are... It's almost like a flake in a liquid form. If that makes any sense at all. I feel like there are very, very tiny flakes in suspended in the liquid. That means for me that this is how I use them. Because if I have a formula that is more flaky than particularly, because my eyelids have, especially in the beginning, have a specific kind of texture and my folds go like that, it then kind of crackles. So that can happen with this. Now, I did not use them all over the lid, and honestly, I don't know if I will, because this is what I like to do right now. I can use them all over the lid, but I honestly don't know if I want to. Maybe I will, or just in the inner corner, but you can use these to spruce up. How would I use them? Yes, you can just smear them on, but I honestly would use them with a brush, because I feel like you have more control that way. My favorite colors, yeah, are these two. I knew that. I knew that these two would be my two favorites. And then here is the blue one, which I think it's very pretty as well. And it's, yeah, it is pretty. I can see the shift, but I don't know if it translates on camera. Would I recommend these? Yes, they retail for, I think, €5 each if you can get them. As far as I know, they're only available in Europe, though. I'm very happy that I bought them all, that I bought the ones that I could. Now, there were some very interesting colors there. There was also one that was more green. I kind of want to see if they will bring that one back. Or maybe they will come to Cosmetic for Less and I can get the two colors that I'm missing right now. Because I think they're very pretty. And for honestly, for €5 each... Then the next thing that was new were the falsies. Yeah, I already said that, right? Yeah, the falsies are cute. They're not my my style necessarily, because they are a little bit more on the softer side for me. But I do like them. They're comfortable. They're a little bit more stiff than the ones that I have from Primark, for instance. But that's usually when you use them first. You kind of have to break the band a little bit. They are very, very long, though. I had to cut off basically my thumb. Or my pinky in width. So they're very long. So if you have very big eyes, these could be something for you. So yeah, I think that's going to be it for today, guys. The tattooiness. Oh, I love it so, so much. I am going to go back in a few weeks when it is healed to see if it needs to, if it needs some touch up. He wants to touch up the bumblebee a little bit. So if this one needs a little bit of touch up, he will do that just in one sitting. And yeah, and I will leave all their info down below. That was it for today. Let me know if this was entertaining. And as I said, I am planning on filming my basically tattoo journey. And I kind of want to do it chronologically. Is that the word? In a timeline. I think that would be fun. That will be interesting. And I think it will be interesting for me as well. Because I then can kind of see the evolution that is me. I don't know when it will come, but it will come. And the Q&A I will film very, very soon as well. And then that is going to be it for today. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I am going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck. And I will see you very, very soon in my next one. Bye, guys.